Hi guys, in today's video we will see the difference between AWS CloudFront and Cloudflare. So both AWS CloudFront as well as Cloudflare are content delivery network, or called CDN in short. So CDNs, basically how they work is they store or distribute cache version of the websites and keeps them at different servers around the world. These servers are called edge locations. So as you can see in the diagram, so the first point in a CDN delivery CDN network is called the origin server. So the origin server will be hosting the actual source code of the website, so it can be HTML code, etc. Then the content delivery network loads the source code from the origin server and creates a cache version of the same and stores and distributes it across all the edge locations of its network around the world. So now when a user tries to access the website, the edge locations which will be nearer to the user is used to serve the request of the user. So this helps to reduce the latency while accessing the website, and hence it gives the user a much better experience of accessing the website. So this is how a basic content delivery network works. Cloudflare works on a principle of reverse proxy. So what it means is Cloudflare actually takes control of the name server of the website. So when you host a website, all websites will be having a name server. So this name server is the entity which helps to locate that specific website. Now in case of Cloudflare, this name server has to be changed so that it points to Cloudflare. So basically Cloudflare controls the name server. Whereas in case of AWS CloudFront, the name server doesn't need to be changed. So CloudFront doesn't control the name server. Let's take an example of a website. Let's say we have a website abcd.com. Now in case of Cloudflare, the contents of the websites are directly loaded from the origin server. So what basically it does, Cloudflare loads the static content of the website and creates a cache version of the same and spreads or distributes it across Cloudflare's network of edge servers around the world. Whereas in case of AWS CloudFront, since CloudFront doesn't control the name server, it cannot directly load from the origin server. So what it does is it loads the contents from an intermediate URL. So in this specific case, it is cdn.abcd.com. So in this example, so abcd.com is the origin server. So it can be AWS or it can be an external server as well. So the contents of the websites are pulled from the intermediate URL, which is nothing but the nearest AWS CloudFront edge server. I hope it's clear. Since Cloudflare has a control of the name server, so it can directly load the site content. But this approach is slightly different from a traditional or a usual CDN concept. So in case of AWS CloudFront, it internally takes care of pulling the data from the origin server or the server which is actually hosting the website, which can be an AWS server or it can be an external server. So basically, CloudFront internally takes care of the process of pulling the data from the origin server to its network of servers or the network of edge servers. So this is how the way CloudFront works is the traditional or usual way of content delivery network functionality. This is how most of the CDN concepts or CDN technologies work. Now coming to the pricing, so Cloudflare has both free as well as paid options, whereas AWS CloudFront is paid only option. Also, more number of websites are currently running Cloudflare service. So as of now, more than 9 lakh websites are using Cloudflare service, whereas CloudFront has a lesser number of websites. So as of now, there are lesser than 2 lakh websites which are using AWS CloudFront. I hope you find this video helpful to understand the difference between CloudFront and Cloudflare. Thank you.